my partner would tell me, did you know who you were talking to last night? You know, she was beautiful, or he was a really great looking guy. Who was he? And I would not even remember talking to them.
When your partner would tell you that you did these things the night before and you didn't remember, would that concern you or frighten you?
Not at all. Hmm. Not at all. It should have, mm-hmm. you know, but if it ended, I felt I would become boring again. I was never boring in a bar.
Part of it, I think, is they drink to feel normal, right? Mm-hmm. Because they feel like they're a wallflower, right? They have low self-esteem. They're kind of anxious about being in public. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not really part of the party group, at least they weren't. And alcohol helps them feel more like everybody else.
Does it work? I mean, are people...
Well, they perceive it works.
You know, I think the difficult thing often is to know that the criteria actually pretty much describes the variety of people that have this problem, but the individual presentations can have different variations. So there's often people that can drink for 10, 20 years before they have this kind of dramatic loss of control.
I would get up for work and take a shower at 5:30 in the morning, and I would take a drink in the shower.
And what would you be feeling when, before you would take that drink? You would have...
It was a physical need, because I was addicted. The only difference between me and that wino drinking out of a brown paper bag, yeah. was the clothes we wore. I started to isolate myself.
People drink for different reasons, and obviously this is one story. Some people drink because they're celebrating, they're feeling good. Some people drink because they're depressed. Some people like to drink in taverns and bars. Some people drink alone, they're closet drinkers, and nobody knows about it. So the face of this illness is actually many-fold. But the typical story of it starts out pretty good, or at least they think it's good, and then the denial starts to lessen, and then it's pretty clear that they're isolated, they're not drinking like everyone else, and the consequences, the negative social consequences pile up. They're gonna feel alone.
I will always have to walk on that line where I cannot drink like a normal person. I cannot drink, period. But I can control it, just like any other disease out there, with the right medication, with the right therapy, the right meetings, psychiatry. It's a treatable disease that has, can, and will have a positive outlook in my life.